You hear me?
Keep lowering. Good speed.
You hear me? Slow down.
Slow. About 3 feet.
Good.
Stop.
See what he's doing. He's through a pickoff strap between his loading line down to the patient. So now that patient is safe right now. He's on those two line one. Max, do you act on both lines? And now what they're going to do is start hauling the tendon up enough, which will pick the patient off of his rope so he can unhook it. In the real world, just cut it and goes back off and take him off.
Well, they just take him up with the extra rope attached.
You could, but what we were simulating was, like if one of your workers had a lanyard and he was hanging off the beam, and if you did that, you can only go 6 foot off.
Oh, okay, okay. I didn't get the full scenario.
The lanyard's not going to terminate where you need to take him.
Gotcha. Is there a winch up there, or are people pulling?
No, ma'am. What they have is a block and tackle system
Okay.
that is hooked onto it, and as they pull on it, they're getting a 4-to-1 mechanical advantage, and then they're going to be able to reset it. They probably got to go another 3 or 4 feet, and you'll see them stop, and they'll reset that system, and they'll do it again.
Okay.
I guess they're pretty close.
Looks like dead weight to me.
If you're on the other end of that rope, it would feel like dead weight.
Been there and done that.
Okay, which way you want to go with it? Up against that wall or towards this wall? If you go this wall, you'll be able to probably clear that rail.
Has he been the victim every time? Oh my goodness.
He's enjoying himself. He has to volunteer for this job.
Oh my goodness.
Hold back. Stop. I'm going to try. I'll try to do it. I'm going to do it.
Thank you. Well, it's a good test, isn't it?
Those were real sounding.